I'm Tracy Ellis, and this is The Elephant in the Dome, the official podcast of the Washington State Senate Republican Caucus. The legislative session is underway. Olympia Democrats are sponsoring a bill that could increase what you pay for property taxes. Senator Shelly Short joins me. So what can you tell us about this, Senator?
Well, this is a bill that was introduced last year, did not receive action. It's back. In fact, it's going to be heard on Thursday, January 18th, and you can certainly register your opinion by going to our legislative website and following the links to the Ways and Means Committee hearing. Look, this bill would allow the annual growth in property taxes to triple. Folks, let that sink in. There has been no shortage of revenue in the state of Washington. In fact, the carbon tax bill that was passed and you all are paying more gasoline prices for has brought in $2 billion just this last year since it started. You know, there, the state budget itself has doubled. And I do agree some of our local governments are having a challenge, but on average, they're collecting more too. I am concerned at a time when prices are escalating, folks can't afford homes, people market increases in homelessness, and Seattle Democrats are going to support a move that is going to do this. It is absolutely insane. There is no respect for where folks in the state of Washington are really truly at right now. And it's really frustrating. We are going to fight this tooth and nail. But folks, if you have a chance to weigh in, please do. We need your comments and we need your opinion.
Senator Shelly Short, chicken checks, poultry payments, tuna tributes, whatever you call them. Senator Keith Wagoner says there is something fishy going on with checks signed by Washington Attorney General Bob Ferguson. Ferguson is sending out nearly $40 million in checks to consumers after settling a lawsuit against chicken and tuna companies. There have been reports of dead people, people who don't live in Washington, and people who don't meet the targeted income levels receiving Ferguson checks.
When I first heard about it, one of my mother's friends, and my mom's in her 80s, and so are her friends, got a check, and I have lunch with them occasionally, and she asked me about it. I had no idea what to tell her because I wasn't familiar with the situation. And then I started hearing about it on Brandi Cruz's show, The Undivided, and I thought, wow, this is a, you know, transparent in the wrong way, thinly veiled vote buying scheme. And it was kind of unbelievable to me. And 2 days later, I got a check myself. So this money is supposed to go to people who are affected or might be affected or be food insecure or in the lower economic echelons. But clearly, the distribution is just crazy. So I have a bill that, first of all, fixes that. I feel like that money should have gone to food banks that are already struggling right now. There's a great nexus. It's a food cost, and it should have gone to people who are food insecure. And that would translate to any future settlements, too. You know, maybe it's a tech sector bill or something, but those should go to nonprofits that are likely to help affected people when you can't find people who are that you know were affected. The other part about this, though, it's vote buying. And an elected official shouldn't be able to put their name on a check and use that for self-promotion. Nobody should. I mean, if I did that, I think the Attorney General would be the first one to call us out. So nobody should have that unfair advantage with an upcoming campaign or a current campaign in this case. So the bill just wants to do those two things. Make sure, and congratulations to the AG for winning a big settlement. I applaud him for that. Let's put it where it belongs and also not self-promote as elected officials.
That's Senator Keith Wagoner. Senate Republican Leader John Braun is with me now. What are Senate Republicans' priorities for this session?
Public safety. Folks want to keep their family safe, their community safe, and we're not doing well there. We just broke the homicide record in our state for the third year running. We're the worst state in the country when it comes to auto theft. We have real retail property crime issues in our state, so there's a lot of work to do on public safety. Connected to that, of course, is homelessness. We're on the wrong track on homelessness, and we have a long ways to go to get back on the right track. Priority two is, of course, just being able to afford to live. Affordability here in the state of Washington continues to get worse, whether it's food or gas, housing, childcare, healthcare. They've all become unaffordable for more and more Washingtonians. And of course, top of mind right now is the price of gas with the Climate Commitment Act. Somewhere between 45 and 60 cents that's adding to every gallon of gas is making life just that much less affordable for folks, especially folks who have to commute to work. A very regressive tax that hurts the poorest among us the worst, and frankly, so far does little to affect our climate. And then finally, we have a lot of work to do when it comes to our children here in the state of Washington. We have not rebounded fully from the pandemic, and that's particularly true for kids who are already struggling, either struggling academically, economically, socially, emotionally. They were struggling before the pandemic. Those kids haven't rebounded. We have to get them back on a better track. But it's broader than that. It's not just education. There's also challenges with childcare. I mentioned in terms of cost, but also access. And then we have trouble with in our other programs for children, the juvenile justice system. If a youth is convicted of a crime, they have to serve the penalty, but we also want to get them back on a track to a better future. And we're not doing that well right now. Also having trouble in our child protective services and foster care. So across the board, we need to be focused on ways we can create a better future for our children.
That's Senator John Braun, and this is The Elephant in the Dome, the official podcast of the Washington State Senate Republican Caucus. I'm Tracy Ellis.